والإسلام ديني ومحمدا رسول الله.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious and the Most Merciful. Zakat is a cure for stinginess. It is important to note that the human soul tends to be greedy or covetous. This can be observed in a nursing child who feels hurt when their mother nurses another baby, and the child will try to distance their mother from the other baby, even if it's just through crying, as a sign of their suffering. Similarly, in the animal kingdom, we can see a calf attempting to prevent another calf from drinking its mother's milk by butting and keeping the other calf away. Indeed, such selfish tendencies and generosity are qualities that are much needed. Therefore, consider zakat as a means to train and develop ourselves to cultivate generosity gradually, making generosity a part of our own character. This is a significant struggle for a person because the love of wealth often surpasses the love for family and sometimes even surpasses self-love. This is evident when Allah prioritizes the mention of wealth over children in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 46, which states, "Wealth and children are the adornment of this worldly life, but the everlasting good deeds are far better with your Lord in reward and in hope." This is because human nature inclines more towards the adornments of the world, and the inclination towards wealth is greater than the inclination towards other things. When we give zakat, we are training our souls and cultivating a habit of doing noble deeds. Truly, this is a noble act that makes us individuals who have struggled to purify both our souls and wealth. These two aspects are priceless honors, and by eliminating the worst tumor from our souls, namely the disease of stinginess, we will attain the magnificence of perfect faith. It is essential to note separately that stinginess arises when trust in the Creator, who provides sustenance abundantly, diminishes. If someone believes that all their wealth is a trust from the Creator, nothing would hinder them from donating a portion of it to the poor. Stinginess is one of the most reprehensible qualities, and there are numerous verses in the Quran that condemn those who possess this trait. Among these verses are 1. Surah At-Tawbah, verses 34-35. Ubilivis. Indeed, many rabbis and monks consume people's wealth wrongfully and hinder others from the way of Allah. Give good news of a painful torment to those who hoard gold and silver and do not spend it in Allah's cause. The day will come when their treasure will be heated up in the fire of hell, and their foreheads, sides, and backs branded with it. It will be said to them, "This is the treasure you hoarded for yourselves. Now taste what you hoarded." 2. Surah Al-Ma'un, verses 1-3. Have you seen the one who denies the final judgment? That is the one who repulses the orphan, and does not encourage the feeding of the poor. There are also other similar verses in Surah Al-Mudathir, Al-Haqqa, and authentic hadiths reported by An-Nasi'i and Al-Bayhaqi, such as, "Stinginess and faith cannot coexist in the heart of a servant forever." And Allah knows best. Hopefully, this is all useful.
ومحمدا رسول الله.